Well, they said wrap up warm because, you know, the weathermen have been saying, oh, it's going to be cold, it's going to be the beast from the east and wind and snow from Siberia and this, that and the other, and it feels absolutely fine. So I'm glad that I'm only wearing flip-flops. Because this is all unnecessary. I hate wrapping up warm. I hate it. Oh, even as a kid, getting wrapped up in loads of blooming layers of endless fabric. Oh, God, boiling. Right, that's sorted. Comments you've been leaving through the week. What's left over? So I got the rest of the Slim Fast and I piled it all into one cup as much as I could, because there's always a bit that gets stuck in the rim of the tin. Ailra put, wow, Charlie, you actually look great now. Thank you very much. Thank you. K-A-0-S-E, capital N. Dude, you really need to see a doctor or psychiatrist. You're so childish, dot, dot, dot. Okay, I shall go see a psychiatrist or a doctor. They're putting lots of tablets and I'll be a very monotone, general, beige bloke, shall I? Never! Oh, 11.95, new improved funky intro music. That was just something I just slammed together into the YouTube video off standard music available on YouTube's audio library. So I can't remember the name of the music at 11.95, but if you liked it, I might use it more often, because I have been using the same music for a long time now, haven't I? Luke Carrigan, yeah, it's really nice because it's probably more calories than a McDonald's milkshake. You absolutely love that place, haha. Please don't go back to your old ways. Do you know what? I was so tempted last night to go to Mackey D's and I didn't. I was really very chuffed with myself. But then again, I'm sort of scared now because I slag off the Yammersmith McDonald's for being so slow, so much, that I'm hoping to get banned from the place and that'll help my waistline immensely. I mean, the downside is because of the Slim Fast diet thing I was doing, I never got a chance to try the Big Mac. Right, Laura Witt. Oh, you're new. Hello, Laura Witt. Look forward to hearing how much you've lost and how you feel. Did you notice any side effects? Shakes have helped me lose 4 stone along the Fitness Pal app. Enjoyed your reviews. Quick and simple format. What's next? ? Mwah. This is on the Slim Fast review 40 of 40. This is the last day of it. I lost a stone. I wasn't so strict on my meal afterwards because I needed the energy, because if you remember, I did that one day, did Slim Fast only, and I felt terrible. Slight breeze, as is customary, for no absolute reason. And it's blown right into the mic, because I can feel that on the back of my head, which means it's going straight into the microphone. That's my cotton wool making a bit of a scene there. Yeah, that's about a stone. And some people said if it's less... Oh, there we go. Cook and vlog perf. Unless you've lost 2 stone, it hasn't been worth it, mate. I always watch your vids, but haven't enjoyed this recent format, TBH. Really don't mean to be rude, just wish you well. I'm fine, I don't take offence, it's fine. So there we've got completely two conflicting comments. I feel that has been worth it because it's put me on the road now to stop me eating so much sugary stuff and carbs. I'm going to try and get back onto my low carb diet again, and this has definitely given me the push to do it because I've lost a stone. So that makes me feel like I have progressed. I ain't lost as much as I wanted because I wanted to lose 2 or 3 stone, didn't I? But I'm going to get there. I'm going to do it. As you can tell from the beginning part of this video, there was none of this wind malarkey. It's just a suppressed record. You can see the cotton wool moving. I hope this isn't too wind noisy. Let me just put my thumb over the microphone. Luke Carrigan, could you give us the details of what you had on Saturday so we can tell how you're planning and how your thing was doing? Could you give us details of what you had on Saturday so we can tell how you are planning on doing things now? I don't know what that means. It's really rare that I watch my own videos back. You know, once I've done them, I've done them. I do watch a few of them back sometimes to see how I could have re-edited better, but I don't always watch my videos back, so... And Saturday was such a long time ago. When was Saturday? Yesterday. God, fucking flu cough, go away! Right, the video before that was Poundland USB plug not durable. This was the durable designed USB plug that's not that durable. Otto1195 left 2 comments. Wait a minute, you're allowed to have access to tools? I would have thought you were under permanent home-based supervision under these circumstances. It's only a matter of time before either you or others end up with a screwdriver put through the arm or something, lol. Okay, so you broke a wire off, totally disassembled it, snapped a plug tip off, and will probably end up mixing some of the small bits into your food and eating them.
I'm not going to eat a USB.
Every time I take my thumb off, that's when a gust of wind comes. I really do believe that wind just does not like me. And then he says, 22 seconds. Why do I not find this surprising? This is because I put googly eyes on another USB plug, because I like putting googly eyes on things that look like faces, but not on Henry. Henry Hoover is such a stupid thing. They've just put eyes on something to make it look as if it has a face, because they've had to put a mouth on it as well. And the nose is obviously the sucky bit. No. That is not right. So, anyway. That's weird. Tassimo Bailey's review, Daniel Eaton. I bet you can only taste Candarelli after putting five in that tiny cup. It was quite Candarelli, but it did improve it a bit. Some people do actually like it though, and some don't like it. Luke Carrigan has put cold or lukewarm coffee is disgusting. Mine's quite often cold. Luke Carrigan again, hello topper, the latter of which I got an offer at Sainsbury's for £4 each, but I'd two for a pound coupons, which you get if you visit their site. So £6 for two tubs. Amazing. Moving on from fridge to the proper stuff I see, still got a few of them Guile and Temptation seashells in Latte Macchiato flavour, but stick to black coffee. James Griffiths put laughing my head off at this review, three smiley faces. Getting strange looks on my lunch break in my van. Face and then a laughy face. You see, it's really weird because I always associate people watching my YouTube videos late at night when there's no else on. In bed with a laptop on the knees, you know, staring up at her, or looking down the nose and that. Never at work, or in the work van, or out and about on the phones or anything. Because it's really rare that I actually look at my analytics on my YouTube. Really rare, you know. And it is mainly computer, well, laptop, how people watch my YouTube videos. And the hours of the day as well, I've got a distinct pattern of times of the day when people are watching YouTube videos. I tried them and yeah, they are bad. Craig Tiffany, number one and number two is a clue. I didn't even realise there was numbered. Craig Tiffany. Anthony A, can you give me some please? Anthony A, future YouTube, I will be able to reach through the screen and make you a coffee. But until that time, I can't, I'm sorry. Mark Reagan put nice. There's quite a lot of YouTube videos this week, weren't they? Here we go. Here's one of my edgy videos that I like to try to do every now and again, you know, ones that are more shocking. Gets people riled up. Even got the gust of wind riled up. And it's the Donald... I changed the title. I had to put Donald Trump in it. Guns for Schools. And this is where I've commented and just thinking of the stupidity of it. Because now kids don't have to bring guns to school, there will be guns already available at school. Along with the pens and pencils. So, Space and 300, what's next? Let's give students guns, just in case the teacher goes on a rampage. I'm not going to read all the comments out on this, because some of them are really long. please go to the video and read the comments. Because these definitely two distinct fields here, the one who are pro and one who is against. I'm obviously the against, and you're never going to change Americans' minds on guns. It's never going to happen. But what I will say is that in the UK media, whenever there's a gun shoot in American news, it's usually treated with indifference because it happens so often that we just don't care. It's sad, but it's the same old formula. A random kid goes into a school, shoots loads of people. Then we usually get the helicopter shots from the news channels, of American news channels. And then there's usually a rather large, overweight sheriff, or policeman, whatever you like to call them, stood outside the school saying how terrible it's been. And then there's the candlelit vigil, and loads of people weeping around a load of candles and flowers. And then it gets forgotten about within days in days, and that's even being generous, because then usually Americans have moved on to the next massacre. That sounds quite harsh and quite short, but it's true, and it just goes on and on and on, and that's why it's usually treated with indifference with the rest of the world, because nowhere else in the world does it happen so often, even in the most war-torn districts. So that's why I'm very anti-gun. And there's always going to be bad people who are going to get hold of a gun. You know, I'm not totally naive. Criminals are always going to be able to get guns. It's all about making them less accessible. And by putting them in the hands of teachers is not making guns less accessible, is it? You know, some random nutter student or gunman or whatever, or someone with a knife can now just kill the teacher and have access to a gun as well. It makes no sense. So, now I've said my piece on that. The people commenting on this were Specimen300, Anthony A, Kishore Kumar, Jem E, Art1195, Adam Besu, Wowpop, Joe Ryan, Anthony A, and Jordan Chappelle and Reese Roberts. So that's that video covered there, because I don't want to go into it too much. Shepherd's Bush opened, and I'm really, really chuffed. Still not being there yet. I was going to go the next day because the queues was massive, but I hadn't had a chance to go. But tomorrow, I might go on Monday, because I'm hoping that Monday will be quieter than the weekend. Creativity's put all foreigners buying foreign muck. Well, everything's made abroad, whatever country you're in, so that doesn't really mean anything anymore. Luke Kerrigan's put, French range is great, by the way, loads of American stuff. Two nugget pillows. What's a nugget pillow, Luke? Or nougat, if you like to pronounce it like that. It's nugget. Luke Kerrigan, the queue in Lidl, South Clark Street, Edinburgh is like that all the time. Students live there, not joking either. You should go to Walland & Barrett and review grenade bars. Buy one, get one half price. I know, yeah, since I'm going to be going to Lidl a lot more now, I should be going to Welland & Barrett, which is right next door. So that's that. So I'm just going to wipe my nose because it's running. Still getting over the flu. Where was he up to? Oh, over 95. I'm going to be going tomorrow too. I love it when he's trying to write it in my accent. It's so funny, I love a 95. I want to go! ! I don't have a Lidl by me. And apparently they're not going to be building more here in the US. For now. Competition here is fierce in the grocery land, so they've changed their plans. At 10 seconds, are people having to register before entering? Show identification, lol. When they open a new Lidl, they usually have some good offers on. The reason why Lidl might not be so successful in America is because Aldi is doing so well, because obviously it's partnership with Trader Joe's. So, and Aldi is better, you know. I do have a more of a history and a more better feeling of going to an Aldi than a Lidl. But in this area, where my only option is Waitrose, Sainsbury's or Tesco, Lidl is going to be huge in Shepherd's Bush. Obviously you get Iceland deliveries quite often, but you can't get everything from Iceland. Like, you can't get everything from Lidl or Aldi, you know, you've got to shop around. But the savings are great. Kishore Kumar. Wow, didn't know Lidl was so popular. Shame on you, Tesco! Yeah, it's because there's nowhere, I mean, there is a Tesco, but it's a bit out the way, and it's a bit in a stupid location. But that Lidl is going to be so busy. Charlie Brown, why is there such a big queue for a new Lidl store? Are they giving stuff away? They are. They sent everyone in the local area, because I've got one myself. I've got this card, and every week you get something for free. And it's useful stuff as well, because it's Lidl. So I think one week it's like some toilet roll, and like another week it's something else. It's like that for 5 weeks. Oh, gosh, wind. We had a line up the street when the Aldi in Maidstone opened. So James Godden and Anthony Airport. Whoa! KFC crisis, my reaction. I think I'm going to have to turn around because the wind is behind me. So, I'm going to move. Look, movement on a Sunday outside. This is like a blast from the past, isn't it? Right. Hopefully, if we do it like this, the wind noise should be less, because now the wind is behind the camera.
Bristol.
Triangle bit of sun there, look. Didn't say that on the weather, did they? So, Alt Love 95. I saw this on BBC News yesterday, and my reaction was they're still in business. Last time I saw it, I went to a Kentucky Fried Chicken, maybe 1997. I'm doubting the people in the US would care if they went out. They are continuously losing sales volume, lol. I love your interpretation of benefits holding mother with kids. Is she from the South East London or more of a small community in the Midlands? Yeah, I was doing a very London-y accent in that video, wasn't I? Andrew Reeks has put, I've never had KFC in my life and I'm 44. I've only been three times and I was massively disappointed. Now it's just constant wind. Maybe it's coming from the side of the buildings. Oh, this is annoying. God, movement again. I mean, on that note, I am trying to do more Sunday outside videos in different locations. It's just getting the days off work. It's been quite a busy February at the theatre more than usual. Quick tip for foul play. Rock band addict 666. Hello, not heard from you for a while. I had to go to Burger King and King, said a woman on ITV News at 10. Yes, she really said that. Yes, that video. The stupid woman in a car. She was like kicking off about the lack of chicken and KFC and that she had to go to Burger King. Andrew Reeks put, I'm sorry, just going to wipe my nose again. Andrew Reeks has put ITV News broadcast. Yeah, I had to say that. And then they've linked a video with it, Ray Murray. Hi, Ray Murray. Linked a video into it. And it was so stupid. And Andrew Reeks has put, she's the kind of person you dread if you work in customer service. Exactly, Andrew Reeks. Because you'd feel like saying to her, well, just fuck off to Burger King then. Do you know what I mean? Sorry about the language, but when people come into your place of work and think that mentioning a rival place or speaking to you like dare is gonna get them an extra foot up the ladder, it doesn't work like that. Don't be rude. That's wipe my nose again. Then Andrew Reeks made a chicken crossing the road joke. Why did the chicken cross the road? It gave up waiting for DHL to take it. Oh, such a bad thing. And then some people have said, oh, that actually this might work in KFC's favour because people might start rushing back to KFC now that the chicken's getting delivered. Not necessarily. It doesn't always work out like that. You know, quite a lot of good rivals have made a lot of money and they'll do whatever it takes to keep it. So I don't think that KFC are going to have the big sales boost after this catastrophe is what they think they might get. JJ's free time. I would call the cops. Okay, let's start. I'm only joking. No, I would move on. Exactly, calling the police. But there's no chicken in a KFC. Get lost, isn't it? Kishore Kumar, the KFC chicken on strike. James Gooden, I think I'm the only one here who actually likes KFC. I think it's better than McDonald's and Burger King. I wouldn't call the police, though, especially when I have a Burger King and McDonald's less than 30 seconds away, lol. You know, KFC is just weird. The reason why I've never really enjoyed a KFC is because in Hull there wasn't a KFC for years. And then there was an East Hull, but then that was far too away because I'm from West Hull. So it was a really long way away. You had to get like two buses just to go to a KFC. No one's going to do that. And it was attached to an old Quicksave as well. I remember that much. And it wasn't even nice looking. It was like a faded sign and everything. It was horrible. Art Love 95, lol. From Tower Hamlet, oh yeah, then Art Love 95 references Tower Hamlets police requesting people to stop calling them. Mark Smith, I say buy your own chicken and cook it yourself. Exactly. Coming up to the last of my videos now. Luke Carrigan has put, just be sure to finish with a green or we'll have to deem the whole 40 days a failure. I know that was with the I forgot to bring that downstairs when we chat with the progress. Art Love 95. So basically what you've got out of this is a piece of graph paper that looks like a weird from that weird video game with squares filled in pretty Christmas colours. Yes. But no, I lost a stone. Oh, Poundworld's Len Pad review. That's that Poundworld thing. And as soon as I say that, the first comments from Otter Love 95 with the way I say Poundworld, as in same world as in WERLD, world. Poundworld, lol. Anyone who thinks this speak and spell is out of your range, Charlie, which is wrong. Ages 3 and up, you're safe. She sounds like a snotty third generation Japanese person from San Francisco area. What's this Z equals Z? Oh, yeah. How would you say zoo, zipper, zamboni, Charlie? Is that the volume control next to the on-off button? No, it isn't. There was no sound control on that thing whatsoever. James Gordon, haha, nice to see Ashen's etc. video today. Good job, mate. Keep it up. Thank you very much, James Gordon. Luke Kerrigan, that and tat, your funniest pronunciation. That and tat. That and tat. That tat. I don't like saying the word tat. 11:30 had to me, said Luke Kerrigan. Oh no, I forgot to watch that video back to know what happened at 11:30. Can't remember. Luke Kerrigan, that's so funny. Just today I was in Sainsbury's and this couple got the fright of their lives when there was a staff call. They do seem louder in Sainsbury's though. Has that distinct... I know, yeah, shop tonight announcements are really loud sometimes, aren't they? And I've noticed that in Sainsbury's a few times. And on tonight as well, it's like an unwritten rule, but everything has to be said twice. It's always like, can all till operators please go to the tills? That's all till operators to the tills. You know, it's always twice, isn't it? You know, can Charlie please come to the manager's office, please? That's Charlie to the manager's office. Read that a few times. That sounds really bad in all contexts, but not really, not really. It's just because I've worked in many places, that's all I meant. That sounds really bad. It makes me sound like some sort of terrible employee. Or whatever. Look, Aragon, food reviews are your best, and used to have a leap pad. Do they still even make them? I don't know, I remember seeing them being advertised. Craig Tiffany's put Z. I think you mean Z. Scoop 6 winners put your nails are hideous. And not Oliver 95 put lol. I have very long sales assistant's nails and they're growing back again. I cut them and they're growing back again very, very quickly. My nails grow really fast because I'm a bloke. And I think I read somewhere that men's nails are whiter and grow faster. Oliver 95, is the volume in the upper right corner? No! Finally, this was 4G. BP and it would entertain and educate. It's money well spent. Oh, fuck. It's because it's not in capitals, so I said the letters. GBP. Yeah, for great British pounds. Would entertain and educate. It's money well spent. I've learned stuff already. And you know how bad I'm spelling too. I think this is my last video coming up now. Slim Fast 38 of 40. I know I've still got my fridge. Oh no, yeah. Nearly. Hiya Charlie. Up, it's going great, says Anthony. I did my 3 weeks of Slim Fast, planning to do more though. But for this week and then the next, I've been on water fast trying to boost my weight loss, and I think it's especially important to detoxify my body in this way. Well, peace. Hope you haven't noticed my absence in this couple of videos lately. I'm commenting a lot at first. It's fun. It's always nice to read comments, and I don't expect anyone to comment on every single video. It's just nice when you do comment, because then I can read your comments out at the end of the week on Sunday outside. Artlover95, when are you going to announce the winner? I don't know what that's about. I haven't done any competition announcements on my channel. Luke Kerrigan, hope we will get stay updated when you're eating, etc. after this. Well, yeah, like I said at the beginning of this video, I'm going to start doing my... low carb diet because I need to lose this weight. Got some tips, but well done, a stone. Wow, keep it up, Charlie. Thank you very much. On that note, as well, because I've not really spoken about it, I have saved a colossal amount of money because I'm not buying sandwiches every 5 seconds. So I have saved loads of money because I'm not eating and walking in down the street, which probably makes me look better as well because I'm a terrible street eater. Slimfast 37 of 40. Sorry, it seems like I'm putting similar comments on these videos, but can you say yourself that it was going to be a bit repetitive? Yeah, it was a repetitive series, wasn't it? It was just me standing on some scales, necking a couple of milkshakes. Still taking the credit for recommending them non-vitality flavours. Next time you start a diet, just get advice from me first. Great to see you back on track, said Luke Carrigan. Andrew Reeks, every cloud has a silver lining. Well done, Charlie. Well done, said John O'Hara. Oliver 95 said, Ebola, where are you? Oliver 95, maybe you haven't noticed, but people catch certain diseases, benefit from losing weight, and goes on about that. And Anthony A. First, woo! Hi, Charlie.
Hello.
And that's it, I'm done. That's all my YouTube videos. Thanks for watching. Please scress. Keep scressing. Thanks for watching. And I'll see yous when I see yous. Bye. Bit of a sharp ending to my YouTube video this week, isn't it? So yeah, anyway, bye, bye, bye. And don't wrap up overly warm in future. Only wrap up warm if you feel the cold. Bye.